Hello, everybody. We're back here with my GM. And I know I did say I wanted to quit this, but I figured I should just return to the fundamentals of the game and start off on rookie and try to actually learn some tricks in that. Because really, thinking about it, this game is kind of like my calculus class. Because if you don't know the fundamentals of calculus, then you're going to do poorly. And the fundamentals are pretty much like differentiation and integration and stuff like that. Some of the basic calculus stuff. But if you don't know how to do that, then you're not going to do good at it. And same for this game. Since I don't really know some of the basic stuff of the game, I'm going to do poorly. So I figured, why don't I just start off on rookie and try to work myself up to higher difficulties. Just like calculus, you gotta start off with simple problems and then work my way up to more difficult problems. So, that's what I'm gonna do instead of getting frustrated. So, alright, we're gonna play the Bucks here. Oh boy, we got some MyGM stuff to do. Let's do it. Howdy, T-Rock, I have a little proposition for ya, if you're interested. Hear him out. I'm always interested in hearing what you have to say, Tyler. Shoot. Thanks. So I think we could really increase our attendance if we spent some money and ran a special promotion. What do you think? All right. Let's do freaking Popsicle Night. I think we should sponsor a Coach Malone Popsicle Night. Yes. Everyone loves popsicles. Am I right? Yeah. That's correct. Popsicle Night. You are being offered the following trade. Nuggets receive 2018 first round pick in Bundinger for Kyle Korver. Let's negotiate. Freak. So they want to give me a first round and Budinger for Kyle Korver. That's like my only shooting guard right now, though. How old's Kyle Korver? Kyle Korver's 34. Problem is, I wouldn't have a shooting guard, though. Can I have a shooting guard, please? I don't know. First round pick sounds good. Yeah, I don't know about that. Losing my only shooting guard, and that position will suck. Decline. Alright, what's happening here? T-Rock, I'm sure you know about this already, but just wanted to remind you, you have a game coming up against LeBron James, who's one of the league's absolute best small forwards. You should take a look at the game plan. Well, I'm not even facing the team, so. Chris Paul, of course. There. Suggested. There. We'll drop minutes. Drop minutes. We'll do all suggested right now. I think we got all of our minutes there. Thad Young's working his way up. Alright. Oh yeah, we beat him. Yeah! Heck yeah. Now only if I could win some games now. I should start up NBA My Team. Which area of your team are you currently the most pleased with? Depth. I'm excited about the depth we have coming off the bench. There we go. Screw that reporter. He's a douchebag anyways. Now what's happening? Is it starting the game up, or is it another talk with the staff? Nope, it's the game. Alright. We're like right in the middle. Should beat the Bucks, especially since it's I lowered that difficulty.
Pre-game show.
All right, here we go. Let's watch Shaq and those guys.
Welcome to 2K Sports, everybody. Thanks for joining us. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, and Kenny the Jet Smith. And coming right up, we'll see the Milwaukee Bucks playing against the Denver Nuggets.
Uh-oh.
Looking at the last game for the Nuggets, it was a win against the Mavericks in Dallas. That game, a high-scoring affair. We'll see if this one turns into a shootout as well. We're going to be watching Joakim Noah in this one, former Defensive Player of the Year. What he gives this team goes far beyond what you see in the stat sheet, though. And, Shaq, you used to go surfing with him in Hawaii.
Surfing?
Is this correct? Is this correct?
Yeah, we had to stop because, you know, he's a wild child. I'm out there one day. He's behind me. I fall off. When I come up, his surfboard hits me in the head. I got a gash on my head. So no more surfing with
me. Oh, that's where that gash came from?
Yeah.
What?
From him.
But, come on,
yes,
man.
Yes, yeah, but, you know, he's my guy. You know, what I like about him is his energy and presence on the floor rub off on everyone else on the team. He's an emotional leader, and the way he plays, it just motivates everybody out there. But man, no more surfing for me in this guy.
Have you been surfing with Joe?
Never been, but I didn't know he was that team-oriented where he would just, like, be part of a surf crew. But that guy plays great on both ends of the floor. His passing ability, his leadership, what makes him different. But now his surfing skills makes him the best NBA center.
You really believe he went surfing with Joakim Noah?
I would love the video from that.
Really? All right, Noah. Freaking put your surfing skills to work this game. It's not even an important game.
Welcome, everyone, to this 2K Sports broadcast live in Milwaukee at BMO Harris Bradley Center. It's a one-game replay.
Right, here we go.
Bucks here with their Milwaukee fans, and then back on the road. After dropping the first three games of the season, they need to turn it around.
The free.
And I think it's an important game. They only faced this club twice this season, and you mentioned that loss in the first one. You hate to get swept in a season series.
Well, I agree with you. It's about pride and competition. You want to hold your own against every team you face. That's how you get respect in this league. You got to win games. You got to beat teams.
Oh.
Them thinking they've got your number. Handle your business, and the respect will come.
My rebound.
Now, let's take a look at Denver's opening.
Dang it.
Trevor Ariza out there with David Lee. Then it's Chris Paul. Then there's Kyle Korver. And it's Noah in at the center position. And Waiters kicks to Towns. Stolen by Noah. And now the Nuggets. Fast break from 10 feet out. And there's Korver on the assist by Ariza. Korver's got the first points up on the board.
All right,
for the
here
Nuggets.
We go.
And for Terrence Jones, there's a quiet excitement surrounding him in personnel circles. Last season, he was a much better rim protector, way up in blocks, and his three-point percentage was up as well. So those are the kinds of year three improvements that talent evaluators are always looking for, especially when you come into the league.
I was going to go in no matter what.
And Milwaukee has possession. It's a five-point game. Defeated by the Hornets in their last game, they'll try to put that one behind them.
Yeah, major problems at the charity stripe in that game. They just could not convert their free throw.
And that makes it hard to win, especially on the road. You get a chorus of about 20,000 yelling at you every time you put one off the rim. Well, that's got to wear on you.
And it's Korver off the drive. And there's another one.
Yeah.
How about three or four from the floor to start? That's always
my goodness.
A good sign.
Clark, some tough offensive sets. They want to turn it around.
Yeah, they need a basket just to regain some momentum here, Kevin.
Here's Jones. And that time, also a missed shot.
And you can see the defenders afraid to kind of get in his way a lot of times when he's on his way to the basket. But on that one, they were there.
Now, here's Ariza.
Oh my goodness. See, this is why I was freaking playing on pro, because this was what would happen if I put it on rookie. I'm doing the same exact stuff as when I lose the on pro. Freaking garbage.
From 15 feet away, and the jumper is on the mark.
It took them a while, but finally they take the lid off.
You know, sometimes all it takes is one to get a team going. We'll see if that's the case here.
Now here's Paul. Boy, was he something else against Dallas. Korver gets a wide open look. Good, and Paul
boom.
Gets the assist. 6 points in the game for Kyle Korver.
A big part of this run here has been their ability to hit from mid-range, guys. I mean, that's unique.
And a lot of teams shy away from that mid-range, but if you can get them off of rhythm, then you can have success.
Now here's Jones. Looking at his point production, he averages almost 11 points a game.
Oh, screw that.
Last year at home to start the year.
Sit your butt down, son.
Leveling at their start, much improved, Greg, from the season before, but fell off, Greg, a touch late in the season.
And Kevin, credit Jason Kidd. I mean, he got this team off to that great start, particularly at home, and they built some confidence, and that helped propel them into the playoffs. Sad to say, they were still near the bottom of the league, though, in attendance.
Here's what Milwaukee's going with right now. Kaminsky is checked in for Towns. Sessions comes in for Waiters. And Zach LaVine subbed in for Drew Holiday. The dish to Bogut.
Dang it. Didn't want to go ahead.
Down low. Oh, and a dunk by Young.
And really, these teams don't even look like they belong on the same court today.
I don't think they do, based on what we've seen. A double-digit lead.
My
we're
goodness.
Still in the first. Ouch. That's painful. Yeah, the Bucks end
now,
the
I wish I could play like this when I'm really actually on higher difficulties. Of course, if I go to higher difficulty, I'll probably get my butt kicked. Doesn't even make sense, because the pro is just one difficulty higher.
Galathis comes in for Kyle Korver. And it's Watson in for Paul. Now, here's Sessions. 14 points from him the last game against the Hornets in Charlotte. LaVine, good.
And one thing that made the Bucks so strong at home was their three-pointers. They're the top in three-point percentage here at home. And easy to get the crowd into it when you knock a couple down from deep.
So it's Denver now after the basket by Milwaukee. Six on the shot clock. And Young kicks to Bellinelli. It's stolen by Johnson.
Darn it.
Here's LaVine. A look at his stats. He averages a bit over 8 points a game. And that one's good. Sessions.
There's a chance he could have a big game if they don't D him up more tightly on the perimeter.
We'll go to Dorisburg, who spoke with head coach Jason Kidd. Doris, what's the news there?
He talked about the impact of opposing big man Andrew Bogut, saying there just aren't that many seven-footers with his kind of game. A great interior defender first and foremost. We can't get tunnel vision when we attack the rim. He's got size and strength, and we can't allow him to bully us for offensive rebounds. Let's see if they can keep Bogut from having a big game, guys.
Thanks again, Doris. Looking at Denver, they got their last win against Dallas.
And they ran their offense nearly to perfection.
Yeah, there we go.
Very few possessions were wasted.
Yeah, they put the mute button on them that time. I mean, in front of a hostile crowd, they never let the fans get going. They silenced them over and over again with big, timely shots.
Here's Sessions. The Nuggets getting the bucket. Kaminsky. Bellinelli pulls it in.
You're not going to see that very
go,
often.
Go, go, go.
Plenty of space, but he just, let's face it, he whiffs on that one.
And that one's good.
Fantastic ball movement. They're picking them apart with their passing.
Purposeful passing it is, partner. Their last 10 points have all come off assists.
Here's LaVine. Johnson the screen. The shot by Kaminsky. Nobody around. And he connects on the jumper. The screen did the trick.
You can't afford to give him that kind of a look.
Well, you know, he came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you've got to do a better job of fighting over and through that.
Watson kicks to Young.
Come on,
inside.
Man. Passing's terrible.
Dishes to Young. Just three on the clock. Tried to bank it in. And before the game, star center Joakim Noah talked about the intensity.
I feel like we're the hungriest team in the NBA. That's a great feeling to be able to say that. Like, whether we shoot the ball well or don't shoot the ball well, win or lose, we know that we're going out there every night, giving everything we got with no regrets.
You know, I think Joakim can certainly make a case, Clark, for Chicago being that famished five, especially with Rose back on the court.
There's no doubting that, Kevin. I mean,
come
even
on.
The addition of Gasol
Let's
with
make
his
this lead higher.
The way he left things in L.A., that left him with an appetite that has him still hustling.
And welcome back. It's been all one-sided so far through the first quarter as our second quarter gets underway. And when you consider how Denver is doing, guys, what are your thoughts?
Just the start they're looking for in this game. Solid offensively through the first.
Very crisp and sharp. Not much stagnation at all on offense.
We've got Brown, Holiday out there with Deion Waiters. Then it's Kaminsky and it's Towns. And at the pivot spot, Manning the middle. That's the group for Milwaukee right now.
And guys, Deion Waiters is a man who has never met a shot he didn't
nice.
Miss. Despite shooting less than 40% from the field last season, he just kept on shooting. Now, every once in a while, he'd get hot and it would look good. But when he's off, which was most of the time, it didn't look very good. He's got to improve shot selection and shot discipline.
Towns sets the pick for Holiday. Kaminsky kicks to Waiters. Three on the clock. The 19-foot shot. Shot is good.
Uh-huh.
Lead is cut down to just 12 points on the bucket from Kaminsky. Kaminsky's gone 2-for-4 so far here tonight. Ray, getting back to Waiters, there's a reason the Cavaliers dealt the former fourth overall pick in the draft. Not only did he shoot poorly, but Clark, he averaged less than 2 assists a game.
Yeah, I think it's a mindset adjustment with Waiters. I've loved his talent and
his ability
to make plays and shots. Now he just has to recalibrate his thinking so he can be effective in the role he's asked to play.
Timeout called, the Bucks. Last game against the Nuggets, they lost in the Mile High City.
And that was an ugly loss for them last time playing these guys. And really, the rebounding differential was the key.
They got worked over on the boards. That's about as plain as I can put it. You can't leave your teammates on an island down there. You need everybody going to the glass.
Come on,
Towns.
Towns,
the pass to Holiday. 6 to shoot. Goes up and lays it nice and easy. Holiday's got his first 2 points of the night.
And that's a great piece of work to get to the hoop there. Just tore the knee to shreds.
Picked by Lee. Paul against Holiday. Paul dishes to Ariza. On the wing, Korver. Brown against Ariza. Here's Lee. Again, the
another pass put right into the shooter's pocket, right in the shooting pocket for a terrific assist. They've done a lot of that today.
And it's something we haven't seen much of at the opposite end of the floor.
And Waiters kicks to Towns. Pass to Kaminsky. Bucks passing it around. Towns dishes to Brown. Now the feed to Towns. Releases. And it's off the
nice.
Rim. No
go,
good.
Go, go.
Denver leading by 14. Tanking is something that all teams that are out of it tend to do.
Oh! I hate
that word, Clark, but it seems to be the one used by a lot. Nuggets didn't really try to hide it last season either.
Well, you know, it certainly looked that way. Right around March, they just started sitting key players for no real reason. They framed it as risk.
Boom!
It didn't quite look that way.
Mm-hmm. The Bucks have gone 2-of-5 from the field here in the second quarter, shooting 40%. Holiday, the pass to Towns. There's the screen. Back to Holiday. Towns sets the pick for Holiday. Reverses. Noah with the block.
Yeah.
That's a 2 from Paul.
Boom.
Shot goes down. Very quick possession right there. And a chance now to catch up on some numbers here. The hustle stats for Denver.
Boy, you have to admire their intensity in the paint defensively. I mean, really contesting and even blocking shots. Definitely a factor early.
And the other thing that's been equally as effective is the fact that they've gotten out on the fast break. A lot of points coming in transition.
Yeah. Excellent
ball movement there, guys.
And that's keyed this run. Passing it with purpose. The D hasn't been able to keep up.
And Holiday kicks to Kaminsky. 1:43 left in the second quarter. Waiters dishes to Towns. Here's Brown, 5 on the clock. And over the rim and in. 1:30 left in the second. Paul against Holiday. Paul kicks to Ariza. Outside Korver, over in the corner, Paul. Shot clock at 6. Stolen by Holiday.
Dang it!
And here comes Brown, leading the fast break. The pass to Waiters. It's deflected.
And with him missing literally everything he's put up today, you can see why the score is what it is.
Took him no time at all on that one.
There we go.
Points for Trevor Ariza.
All right, I think I'm going to keep it on pro.
Clark, they've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a little bit of cotton mouth here. Dry spell for sure.
Here's Waiters. And five.
Seems like I'm all right at the game on rookie.
The Bucks have converted one of two free throws so far today.
I'll just put it on pro. This is kind of boring a little bit.
One of the things they've done, guys, is taken pride in their free throw shooting this season. And rightfully so.
And guys, a lot of problems for the Nuggets last year. Ended the season with a 30-52 record and really struggled even against the Eastern Conference.
Looking at who's out there now for the Bucks. Terrence Jones has checked in for Towns. Sessions comes in for Brown. And Zach LaVine subbed in for Drew Holiday. Young inside, working on Jones. And Jones.
Foul! Screw that guy.
And it's the Bucks on the break. And it's blocked.
Trailing here in the game, you can look at his performance as a direct indicator of why they're losing.
And that one's good.
And an open path to the hoop there. Easy bucket. We've seen that far too many times today.
Sessions with it.
Ah!
The Bucks have made two and missed two at the line tonight. That free throw, no good.
Taking two shots.
And he can't make the second free throw either, missing both. Got it off in time, and the release was
before
the buzzer, but it's off target. And through the first half, a pretty lopsided affair. Denver on top as they end the second quarter on a 20-7 run. And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Well, David, obviously a very strong first half. What's been the philosophy of this team and how you mentally set your focus as a group to come out and play your best basketball?
We just need to keep being consistent. We're a team that's going to stay humble. That's not an issue with us. We're trying to play defense, rebound the basketball, and then just share the ball in offensive ways as a team.
David, it's been a complete change in culture. Thank you for your time. Over to you guys.
Thanks so much, Doris. And we'll step away briefly, but get you right back in there for the start of the third quarter after this break.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime
All
Show.
All right, let's see what we got. Finally, they'll say good things about me.
Hey again, everybody. We've been watching a pretty lopsided game through the first half, that's for sure. I'm Ernie Johnson, joined again by Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith. Denver came ready to play. They went to work early at both ends of the floor, going on a 9-0 run to jump out in front. And it was a 9-point lead for them as they finished the first quarter. Then in quarter number two, it was all hands on deck, and what a show it was. Quality execution, good efficiency, some tremendous defensive play helped them take a decisive advantage, and they're running away with this one. Kenny, your thoughts on the Nuggets' first half?
They looked like they were playing an easy game of pitch and catch out there. The playmakers and finishers were in sync on every level. The assist disparity, now that was big. Now that's the reason why it's a blowout right now, and they play well.
And you, big fella, let's get your thoughts on the Bucks.
Well, when you look at the opponent field goal percentage, that tells the whole story. They gave up way too many good looks. When they come out of the break, they got to play way tougher, Ernie. Get those hands up. Get in your opponent's face. Do something.
And that's it for halftime, as the second half is just about to get underway. See you after the game.
All right.
Well, it's been a one-sided affair so far.
All right, let's see what we got. But there's plenty of time to mount a say how many points he'll score in the second
great
half.
Great performance by Kyle Korver.
I know we've said this many times before, but what a great first half. Just an offensive juggernaut.
And, you know, in the end, I wouldn't be surprised if we're talking about what a great second half he had, guys. I mean, he can usually keep it going for all four quarters.
Taking a look at the Nuggets, David Lee is out there with Noah. Then there's Kyle Korver. Then it's Trevor Ariza. And it's Paul in at the point guard position. Goes up the baseline. Count that one.
Boom.
Paul's got his third basket of the night right there.
And really, it looks like he may just try to take this thing over on his own and really build that lead up. And obviously, Chris Paul's one of the most highly recognized players in the game. High school All-American, college All-American, NBA Rookie of the Year. I mean, the list goes on and on.
Clock at two, Jones. And it's Denver with the rebound.
They've shown effort and aggression in the paint right from the tip. Their rebounding edge is
impressive. Yeah. And they're giving themselves extra possessions and have taken advantage of it. And that's critical. You can shoot a few lesser percentage if you're getting more opportunities at the rim.
Highly decorated Chris Paul, multiple NBA all-team selections, all-defensive team selections. No MVP yet. It's probably right around the corner, though, for him.
Yeah, you know what? He's only worried about one thing, though, and that's hoisting that Larry O'Brien championship trophy at some point in his career.
Lee against Jones. Good
miss
by Lee.
And typically he has the touch to finish when he's in tight, but not sure on that possession.
Oh! I didn't get to set my shot
for
up.
Milwaukee, they've gone
very well there.
Starting the second half. Holiday, the pass to Waiters. Double team on Holiday. They set the pick. Jones dishes to Holiday. Jones with the screen on Lee. Holiday.
Oh!
Holiday's got his second bucket tonight.
A lot of space right there to get that shot off.
Not a very good job of the defender getting over the top of that screen in that particular play.
The Nuggets leading by 22. The drive by Paul. It's stolen by Brown.
Oh, come on. Bullcrap.
Down low, here's Towns. It's hauled in by the Nuggets. Lee's got his fifth rebound in this one. Well, Milwaukee last year became just the ninth team in NBA history to go from Greg being the worst in the league to a playoff team.
Unbelievable what they accomplished. And they had a tough matchup in the first round with the playoff season Bulls, however. Things didn't go well, but they did get some valuable experience that effort.
Nice.
The Bucks have gone 2 of 5 shooting here in the third quarter. Here's Jones. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down. Jones has got 5 points so far.
You know what? That's what you like to see. A perfect pass leading him right into the shot. Didn't even have to break stride.
Paul gets to Ariza. And a great assist
to
Paul as that one goes in.
Oh, my
Paul's
goodness.
Paul's got 3 assists in the game. Bucks have gone 3 of 6 in the third quarter, 50% from the field. Brown the pass to Towns. Towns sets the pick for Holiday. Denver grabs the miss.
Boy, there was no hand in his face right there. I thought for sure he was going to knock that down.
The shot's good from Paul.
Boom.
They're 6 points on consecutive three balls. They're finding holes in this defense.
And no doubt the defense had better play a little tighter.
The kick out to Holiday. Again, Holiday missing.
The clear look at the hoop. He doesn't miss many of those.
It's Ariza on the wing. He's covered by Brown. And that one's good.
Boom!
16 points in the game for Kyle Korver.
defensively. They just look out of sync, not closing out on the threes in time.
Well, I think they're getting
caught in. Darn it, I couldn't see my guy off the screen.
No man's land, giving up three straight from beyond the arc right now.
It's dang it! Well, how does it keep losing the ball? What the freak?
1:37 left to play here in the third. Towns with it, working on Noah. And that one's good. Towns has got six in the quarter. 1:24 left in the third quarter. Now here's Paul. 10 points for him. Lee gets to Ariza.
Oh!
Off the mark.
Dang it.
For Milwaukee, they've gone even 5 of 10 on shot attempts in the third. So the whistle blows on the shot and two free throws for the contact right there.
And let's take a quick look now at some stats here for Holiday. Over the last 10 games or so, he's really shown up. 6 in steals, 11th in free throw percentage. And he's in the top 20 in assists per game. His talent for creating easy buckets for his teammates, such an
definitely
asset.
11th in free throws, Matt. I mean,
jumping the passing lane, snatching away your dribble, he'll take it from you.
Here's what Milwaukee's going with.
Oh.
Kaminsky, he's checked in for Terrence Jones. Sessions comes in for Brown. And Zach LaVine subbed in for Drew Holiday. And here's Watson. Taking a look at his numbers, he averages about 7 points a game. And that one's good.
How about the passing? They are moving the ball without any thought, without any individual agendas.
Yeah, and it's really fun to see that kind of unselfishness. Really hard not to appreciate all the assists they've racked up.
Now Sessions, taking a look at his stats.
God,
he's
dang it.
Around 9.5 points a game. He'll take his third and fourth free throw shots of the game right here. No good on the free throw.
You know, the Nuggets could create their offense, but they still would have trouble knocking down the shots. Just didn't have a lot of dead-eye laser shooters. Every field goal attempt with them was an adventure.
And the Bucks making a change here. Johnson's checked in. It's 9 seconds separating the shot clock and game clock. Here's Bellinelli. He's guarded by Johnson. Watson's shot.
Boom.
These defenders are
everyone's getting open.
Resistance to the three-point shot.
And it's killing them. 4 of the last 5 makes coming from long range.
Here's Sessions. Johnson outside. Let's it go with a 3. Off target with that shot.
Yeah.
And at the end of the third quarter, a huge lead, and this one may already have been decided. The Nuggets on top, running away with it. And we're coming back in just a moment. Get ready for the fourth quarter of action when we return. And thanks again for joining us. Let's see what happens here in the fourth. Denver's gone 7 of 11 from deep tonight, using the three-pointer to their advantage. All right, now a chance to set the floor courtesy of Gatorade. Fourth quarter action, all fueled up and ready to go. And Milwaukee, looking at who they've got. They've got Dawson. Johnson is out there with Ramon Sessions.
Oh, my goodness.
That's Kaminsky.
Three-pointers are killing them at this point, and they haven't been able to respond at the other end.
Yeah, and Greg, you know the only way that's going to turn around defensively is by stopping the outside shot, not getting into a shootout. They're not going to out-shoot out this team.
Dawson, the pass to Sessions. Step-back shot, and Baines pulls it down.
Good little two-man action there, but they just can't get the shot to fall.
Yeah, but that was a beauty. Good-looking shot, well-executed.
Oh!
I wouldn't be surprised to see them go back to it.
And for Milwaukee, they're shooting under 40% all in all for the game. They set the screen. Sessions dishes to Kaminsky, loses his man
on
the screen, and lays it up and in.
Great job of screening there. Nice job to take it to the rim and get the finish.
Pass to Watson.
What the freak? My headsets went out.
Well, look, Lee business clearly doing well. Franchise.
Oh, I can't believe I missed that.
Skyrocketing and a new TV deal kicking in next season as well. It represents the largest expansion of league revenues in history.
Come on, guys. Must have been the game sound that went out.
Should continue to get the ball inside. The defense struggling to contain them.
And when you make five in a row in close like that, it also takes pressure off your perimeter guys, too.
Kicks it to Baines. Dishes it to Young. Just five on the clock. And that
was home.
You know, there are a lot of bigger power forwards than him in the NBA, but very few that rise up like he can.
We're about 2 minutes into the fourth quarter in this one, and the NBA's TV deal paying about three times as much per year as the previous deal.
And it's changing the math as far as the salary cap and contract negotiations go. For the fans out there, don't get sticker shocked. The players expect to share in these revenues.
Here's Sessions. The three-pointer, no good. For Denver, they've gone 2-4 from the field since we started the final quarter of play. Watson kicks to Baines. Beyond the arc. And again,
boom!
With the triple.
That's far too good a look to give them from behind the arc.
Three of their last five makes come from beyond the arc. The defense has to react quicker.
And just about 3 minutes through the fourth quarter here, Sessions. Denver grabs the miss.
Boy, blew the easy two by profiling. Trying to look good. That's a bad decision and poor execution.
Young shot is off. Darn it.
You know what? You just cannot get much better of a look than that one.
Exactly. I mean, no way you expect him to miss that shot.
Nice ball movement by Milwaukee. There's the pick. Sessions passes to Dawson. Pat Paul's great assist by Ramon Sessions.
The screenplay worked ideally there, and I'm not talking about the screenplay you see in a movie theater. Gave him more than enough room to get that shot off.
Watson kicks to Young. Now, here's Watson. He's covered by Sessions.
Yeah.
Shot is good.
I love his shot selection today. He set the bar for the rest of the team.
They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Sure could, Kev. I mean, too many empty trips. They need some points.
Here's Dawson. No luck. Now the Nuggets take it the other way. Kolathis dishes to Young. He feeds it to Bellinelli.
Wow. I didn't really want to shoot that.
And over the course of last season, and really the last decade, we have seen three-point shooting on the rise. Teams have been making the most of the efficiency of that shot, and it's a big part of successful offenses.
Oh, come on. In NBA. I shot that off. That's garbage.
Jones just checked in. The Bucks have gone 3-7 from the floor in the fourth. That's a 42% mark in the quarter. Screen by Jones, and Sessions kicks to Jones. Here's Johnson. He sticks that one in from 20 feet away.
Well, guys, this was never really a contest. Just a total obliteration, if you will. And you can safely say mission accomplished now for the Nuggets.
Agreed, Steve. And as one-sided as it gets today, you know, Clark, there were some dominant moments in about every facet of this game for that team.
You're right, Kevin. It's hard to think of anything that didn't go right for them. I mean, game plan by the coaches, execution by the players. Everything was spot on.
And it'll advance their win total up to 12 on the season.
A two-game season series. They win them both and complete.
Of course, he makes it, but my guy doesn't.
It's a nice feeling to get the sweep, even though it is a small number. Still nice to get that sweep.
I mean, when you look at the stats, you'll see just how dominant a game this was for Ariza. Every inch of the floor was his tonight as he came out and injected an energy into every play.
Clock at six. Watson with it. Here's Baines. And a miss there on the triple. 8 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Sessions passes to Dawson. Now here's Sessions. and fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two.
CJ Watson.
At the line for your Bucks, Ramon Sessions.
That free throw, no good. Good on the second free throw. There's 10 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. Here's Calathes.
All
right. So it's the Nuggets winning this one easily. This one was over well before the final buzzer. The fans were waiting for something to get excited about, Greg, but they never got it.
They sure didn't. I mean, they just rolled to this win. They made it look really easy. What an efficient performance at both ends.
And now we'll send it down to Doris Burke, who's standing by courtside.
Well, a nice win for you tonight, Joe Kim. What was the attitude of the team coming into this game and just in general?
Yeah, we played hard tonight. We're getting better. We're getting better. We just got to keep going. You know, it's a work in progress. And, you know, we just got to keep fighting, and get as many W's as possible.
Congratulations, Joe Kim. We appreciate it. Guys, over to you.
Doris, thank you as always. And that'll do it, folks. For Clark Kellogg, Greg Anthony, and Doris Burke, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. Now time to send you over to the award-winning Ernie Johnson for the post-game show with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny the Jet Smith.
The 2K Sports post-game show.
Kevin, much appreciated, and now let's present our Jordan player of the game, Trevor Ariza.
He was dead on from the field tonight, guys. I'd call his performance economical because there were no wasted opportunities. He took advantage of every good look he got. I mean, everything he put up was going in.
You know what, Ernie? I must admit it. I didn't see this kind of performance coming from him tonight. He's been coming off a stretch of game where he just looked lost out there. To see him turn around this quickly, it's a nice surprise. Play after play, he was getting after it, making plays, and making it look easy.
And folks, that's it for us. Thank you for tuning in. Always a pleasure. For Kenny the Jet Smith, for Shaquille O'Neal, this is Ernie Johnson. Have a great night.
All right, so like I was trying to say, I think I'm going to just send it back up to Pro because I don't really want to dominate like this every game. I know the team sucked, but I don't really want to win by like 30 points every game. That's why I really try to use custom sliders in Madden, try to find the best difficulty. So really, if I put it on Pro, I get my butt kicked and I get frustrated. But if I put it on Rookie, it's way too easy and I'm bored. So, I don't know. I guess I'm just going to put on Pro and try to win the games the best I can. So, alright. Well, not going to put it up on Pro and we'll just go from there.